Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time we're going to cover 10 very helpful rhythm guitar strumming exercises, and we're doing this due to a question that was sent in from Joe. He's out in Salt Lake City, Utah. He wrote in saying, I watched your syncopated melody and rhythm guitar lesson on your other YouTube channel. I had trouble playing the rhythm examples. It made me realize I need some kind of routine for developing my rhythm guitar. I can't count time and play, and my strumming is all over. I need some place to start practice from that covers strum direction and the important beats to learn to count. Could I request a general rhythm guitar exercise routine to start at for learning this? From Joe in Salt Lake City, Utah, USA. Well, hey, thanks for writing in, Joe. You know, rhythm guitar can be difficult to learn for some players, although, you know, there are guitar students out there who seem to be naturals when it comes to this subject. But in general, you know, nearly every player will need to practice it to some degree. See, in order to nail down certain rhythm guitar strumming patterns or styles, it will require time spent working with a metronome and some careful study on getting strumming patterns to feel instinctive. This is why it's so very important for every guitar player to spend a few weeks on grooves that involve triplets, 16th notes, and syncopation. And most importantly, a student should learn how to tap their foot to the underlying pulse and count through the proper timing of any rhythm pattern that crosses their path. In getting started with the first exercise, we'll just be using a straight time feel, eighth note duration example mixed with quarter notes. It's going to be very easy to play. Even if you have really no rhythm guitar experience whatsoever, this should be a fantastic starting point. We're going to use also a very common and straightforward chord. We'll be using the E major bar chord off the fifth string root at the seventh fret that gives us E major. Now, on the off chance that that chord is a little bit difficult for you to play, you could also just do root fifth octave power chord. You can just use your index and third and fourth fingers to fret that out. And just let's move on to exercise number one here to get started with. It's going to be a quarter note, two eighths, a quarter, two eighths, and then a series of eighth notes, and then a half note at the end. So the strumming pattern will be down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So learn that first, get an idea of how the structure operates, and then the next idea here will be to turn on a metronome. I have my metronome set at 92 beats per minute, and we're going to count this out. So here we go. 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, 4. Now, if it's difficult for you to use a metronome, my best piece of advice for you would be to count in, give yourself a full measure up front with the metronome, get your body synchronized with it, tap your foot, get your foot moving to the beat of that quarter note that's being given by the metronome, and that should help you get into the jump start for using the metronome. So here, I'll give you a demonstration of that. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you can count in at first, it's going to help a lot of getting used to the use of a metronome, because the metronomes can be a little bit tricky if you're not familiar with their use. For exercise two, we'll be replacing all of the straight time eighth note durations with eighth note triplet durations. Now, with a triplet, we're counting it as triple it. You could get into the strum pattern as down, up, down. If you're doing them back to back, it could be down, up, down, up, down, up. So you can change around how you're doing your strum patterns. And, you know, as stated earlier, we're just going to be using that same E major bar chord for all these studies. If that's too hard, like I'd mentioned, you can use the root fifth octave style power chord as well. But let's take a look at how exercise number two operates. It's just going to be like this. I'll play through for you nice and slow. The strum pattern, by the way, that I've chosen to go with is down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So you don't have to use that one, but my one suggestion would be for strum patterns in more difficult sequences like this is to pick one, get good at it, and try and stick to it Then if you want to alter it and change to something else, develop that one afterward and stick to that, develop that one, you know, and just keep moving through different kinds of, you know, down, up, you know, strum patterns. But it's better to stick with something rather than just kind of change it every time that you do the exercises. But let's move on to getting the metronome involved in this study. I have the metronome a little slower. It's dialed down to 84 beats per minute. And you can also count through them with the proper count. So you could go 1, 2, and a 3, 4, and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, 4. So you could use that method. Or you could concentrate on your down, down, up, down, down. You know, whatever works best for you. I'm just going to play through it and give you a chance to hear this thing. It goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more time. Well, next I'd like to move on to the application of 16th note durations. The drills will operate pretty much exactly like the 8th note drills, except the 8th notes will, of course, all be replaced by 16th notes. So in exercise 3, what we're doing is we're having the same format. We're going to have a quarter note up front, and then we'll have a series of 16th notes. And I suggest on the pattern for strumming for those guys to go down, up, down, up, like just like that. So down, down, up, down, up. So we'll have a quarter note, 16th notes following suit in the first measure. Then in the second measure, it's going to be much the same as we'd seen with the other studies. We'll have the two back-to-back, in this case of the 16th notes, and ending on the half note. So if we're just counting through it, we'll use the count of 1, 2 E and a, 3, 4 E and a. So that's how we'll count through those 16th notes. And I think I'd just like to move right along to getting the metronome incorporated. I have slowed this down a little bit again to 76 beats per minute. And here's how this exercise goes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's the count, 1, 2 E and a 3, 4 E and a 1 E and a 2 E and a 3, 4. And if you wanted to go through it counting through, instead of counting and doing that way, you could do it with calling out your strum pattern. So you could do it as down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, you know, that kind of an approach. Whatever works the best for you, use that. As I'd mentioned before, try not to alter your strum patterns very much. Pick one, get used to it, get good at it, and then move on. With exercise number 4, we're going to enter into some really quick strumming technique due to the appearance of 16th note triplets. Now, if you're not familiar with what a 16th note triplet is, it's 6 strums over top of one click of your metronome. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, it's occurring very quick. Down, up, down, up, down, up. It's very fast. Da, 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 just like that. So get used to the idea of 16th note triplets and practice them. You could even cover your strings, you know, just cover your hand over the strings and just, you know, just do something like that in the beginning. Just to get that feel together for your right hand strumming technique, count it out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you know, keep a metronome very, you know, slow. You know, I have, for the exercise here, I have my metronome set to 64 beats per minute. And basically for the exercise, it's the standard 16th notes being replaced that we had seen in exercise number 3. And they're getting replaced, obviously, by 16th note triplets. So it's that same format with the quarter note up front on the first beat. Then we'll have a 16th note triplet on beats 2 and 4. Then we're going to have two back-to-back 16th note triplets in the second measure, ending on a half note once again, where it just sustains. So here's the full exercise for exercise number 4. It goes like this. So that's how it sounds. You know, practice that without a metronome at first. Get some groove happening with it. Then turn the metronome on and start practicing with the metronome. Keep your foot tapping to the floor. Feel it out so it actually gets right in your mind so you know how it has to sound. And then jump into it after you do your count in. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. One more time. Well, now that we've gone through our first four exercises, we've done a really good warm-up, we've experienced some eighth note grooves, we've tried triplet grooves, we've gotten into 16th notes, our hands are all warmed up, we're used to using our count and our metronome, and the next thing that we're going to move into is a syncopated feel. So it's a little bit different feels, mainly using the dotted eighth note to create an offbeat feel, an offbeat groove. We're going to lose on the beat of three and one. And it's a real shift of gears, though, because we're really feeling on the off-time ideas inside of these measures. There's still going to be two measures to this exercise, and how it's going to operate is we're going to have a dotted quarter note up front on the first measure, and then on the upbeat of two, we're going to have an attack that's going to tie itself over around to the downbeat of three, which will also have a dotted quarter note on that pulse, and then we're not going to attack again until we come to the upbeat of four. That will tie over the bar line into the next measure, where we're going to have another dotted quarter note, and then on the upbeat of two, we're going to have another eighth note tied over to that half note that seems to always appear for us in these exercises on the second measures. So here's how this thing goes. It's going to have a down strum on the downbeat of one, and we'll count through. It'll go one and two and three and four and one and two and three, four. So all up strums after that down strum. And what I'm going to do next is turn the metronome on, get a click behind us, count in, and this time I'm going to just count out loud so that we can hear where all these attacks take place. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and one and two and three, four. Again, one and two and three and four. One and two and three, four. Now, carrying on with the syncopation feel, what we're going to do this time is combine that loss of 3 and 1 with another loss of 2 and 4. So we're going to be a ton of backbeat upstrums on those eighth notes. And it's a really interesting feel. It's kind of, you know, really exercise-ish sounding. I don't know if you'd really hear this very often ever in a song, but it's very good for your counting, and it's great for just getting an overall feel of your timing and control over your strum patterning. So what's going to happen, speaking of strum patterns, what's going to happen here for that is we're going to have our initial attack of one as a down strum, and then after that it's going to be all up strums. And remember, we're losing on both the count of the downbeat of two, four, three, and one. So it's really going to be on the backbeat. Check it out. Here's exercise six. Here's how it goes. You know, one and two and three and four and one and two and three, four. So you can tell just all up strums there. You may, once you get good at this, want to also try doing those as down strums. That's going to be a really different feel. But as I had mentioned earlier, you know, messing around with your strum direction as you're developing your patterns, it's great work for your technique on getting the strums as perfect and as under control, really, as you possibly can. You don't want to have control of, you know, doing them either as down strums or up strums in the long run of your exercising. Now, I'm going to turn the metronome on, and I'm just going to go through this study here and just get you a chance to hear the count as it's going by with the click track in the background. So here we go. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and one and two and three, four. One and two and three and four and one and two and three, four. Once more. One and two and three and four and one and two. Well, in exercise number seven, we're going to move into some syncopated triplet feel ideas. You know, syncopation can also exist on a much smaller level when a groove is generating an offbeat feel within specific note durations. In exercise number seven, I have a very common and very important to learn groove that generates an offbeat feel with the eighth note triplet. In fact, this feel is so common, it's been named the shuffle feel. I'm sure you've heard of it. What happens in the shuffle feel is we basically, around that eighth note triplet idea, is we combine the first two eighth notes of it and we generate a quarter note and an eighth note underneath the triplet symbol. And what happens there is we have the first two the first two eighth notes combined to a quarter, so we have some delay up front, one and up, like that. Now, sometimes, you know, teachers will teach that as shuffle it. So shuffle it. So we have that delay there up front, and then we have that final eighth note getting tagged at the end. So one and a two, three and a four. Now the exercise is much the same as to what we had seen in all our previous exercises. What we're gonna do here though is we're gonna have the shuffle feel occur up front. So we'll have shuffle it and then a quarter note. We're gonna do that again. And then we're going to have two back-to-back shuffle rhythm feels in the second measure. So shuffle it, and then our standard use of that half note at the end there. So you can count this in one of two ways. You could use that term of where it goes shuffle it, or if you didn't want to use that, if that felt just funny to say that and go through working on that, you can count the time. You could go one and a two, three and a four, and then when they're back to back, just make sure you're counting them evenly. One and a two and a three, four. So I'm going to put the metronome on, give us a click track here, and go through this thing. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One and a two, three and a four. One and a two and a three, four. One more time. Well, in exercise eight, the shuffle feel is going to take a little bit different twist and turn here. There's a lesser known counterpart where the shuffle feel pattern is actually reversed. See, within the common shuffle feel, as we'd seen in exercise number seven, we have a quarter note and then an eighth note underneath the triplet symbol. If you'll recall, it sounded like this, you know, shuffle it. So it had that delay up front, ba-da, kind of like that. But in this one, what we're doing here, it's like a reverse pattern. We're now going to have an eighth note appear up front with a quarter note appearing after the eighth. So now it's going to go like this. One and a two, three and a four. So we have that dun-dun instead of the delay. So the delay is happening at the back end now, basically, instead of at the front end. So here's how exercise eight sounds. When you put it together, it goes like this. And if I counted it through, we would just go like this. One and a two, three and a four. One and a two and a three, four. Now I'm going to put a metronome on, give us a count here to go by, and we'll just count through this one. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One and a two, three and a four. One and a two and a three, four. Well, in wrapping up, I wanted to finish things off with exercising offbeat feels. So in exercise 9 and exercise 10, we're going to get into the syncopated feel of 16th notes. Now, this is by far one of the most challenging feels we can work on due to it having a really choppy groove created by shaving the 16th note into any number of different pieces. We could have it as half a beat of a quarter of a beat of time. It's going to be very funny to get used to playing this way. But in exercise 9, we have a loss of the second and third beats in each bar. Remember to keep your metronome to a lower beats per minute. I have my metronome set to 63 beats per minute for this exercise. And I want to also mention something else. Now, you're going to be developing not only a strum pattern that you want to execute through the ideas, but you'll also want to really get nailed on exactly how the feel of the time gets executed as well. And I think just holding a chord and practicing it against a chord constantly, that's going to maybe start to kind of, you know, hurt your hand a little bit. So what you may want to do is just take initially one note, you know, just choose maybe the root of the chord and start with that. And then as you get better at understanding whatever the groove is and the timing is, then you can move on to entering in with the chord. And, you know, the grip of making the chord on the guitar neck isn't going to be so challenging. So anyway, maybe what I'll do is I'll just use one note and I'll play through how exercise 9 sounds as a rhythm. It's basically going to go like this. One E and a two and three and four E and a one E and a two and three and four and again. He'll do it one more time. One E and a two and three and four E and a one E and a two and three and four and. So you can see there, it's very choppy. The syncopation is pretty high on this thing. But I'm going to move into now playing it on a chord, give you a chance to hear what it sounds like on that chord. Just again, nice and slow. One E and a two and three and four E and a one E and a two and three and four and. And I'll put the metronome on now also. And I'll count into that and give you a chance to hear what this sounds with the click, how it sounds with the click track in the background. Here we go. So three, four, one E and a two and three and four E and a one E and a two and three and four and. So it's very choppy, as you can tell, and it's difficult to play with a click track. I'm going to do that one more time, and I'm going to give a better count in. I think I only gave two beats. Let's give a full four beats up front. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One E and a two and three and four E and a one E and a two and three and four and. So that's a little bit better idea you got now of how that thing's supposed to sound. It is going to be challenging, probably the most challenging ones out of, you know, the entire set of 10 that we're doing will, of course, be exercise 9 and exercise 10. So take your time, learn how these things operate, and just spend the time counting through with the metronome, paying attention to your strumming hand, and making sure you're getting the right kinds of directions with them. So next, let's head over to exercise 10. Well, in my final exercise, exercise 10, we'll switch the offbeat loss over to the beats of 2 and 4 this time. The amount of 16th notes will also increase with steady 16ths occurring upon the back end of nearly every beat in both measures. The counting and overall awareness of the feel will be especially important during the study of the practice of exercise 10. So be sure to keep the metronome dialed in slow when you do turn it on. Do lots of work without the metronome. Make sure you understand the count. Pay particular attention to the overall manner that the beats get subdivided and know how you want to do your strum patterns. There is a guide pattern that's given in the handout for exercise 10, so you could follow that or you could just work out one of your own. But whatever you use, make sure you stick with it. That's always really important. Now, I'm just going to do that exercise that we had mentioned earlier in exercise 9, pardon me, where we were saying just to play one note initially. So here's exercise 10, just played on one note to get you started. Here's how it goes. Now, if I count along with that, it's going to go like this. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three and four. So you can tell the sustain there on that last one, we're losing the downbeat of four. Now, let's go and put that on a chord and turn the metronome on so that we can get it going against the click track. Remember to give yourself a count in. So here we go. One, two, three, four. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three and four. So you're going to find that probably a little bit difficult when you first jump into the count against the metronome. Make sure you keep your metronome slow and just take your time with it. Here's exercise 10. Perform one more time. Here we go. So one, two, three, four. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three and four. Well, when it comes to strum pattern exercises, although they do help with short-term exposure to learning different types of grooves, what will end up making the biggest difference to your rhythm guitar abilities will eventually come from two primary areas. And these are, number one, exposure to many different musical styles, and number two, learning a lot of different songs with a band and performing those songs live in front of an audience. So do your best to explore different kinds of music and get together with a the group to rehearse songs as much as you can. When you're able to ultimately take those songs to the stage and they feel good and you start getting some compliments on your playing, think of that point as having rhythm guitar success. Anyway, that's about all the time I have for today. As always, thanks for watching. Have fun working on all this stuff. You can download the handout and an MP3 jam track for this video over at my website at andrewwasson.com. You can follow me on Twitter, through Facebook, and on my guitar blog YouTube channel. The links are all in the description box for you. Take care, everyone. Have a great week, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.